I have spent my life searching for the answers that my father and my father's fathers failed to find. Who were the precursors? Why did they create the vast monoliths that litter our planet? How did they harness Eco, the life energy of the world? What was their purpose? And why did they vanish? I have asked the plants, but they do not remember. The plants have asked the rocks, but the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy. Oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting of my guidance. And why would he want to listen to old Samus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of Green Eco, one of the wisest men on the planet. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking. Nay, as with many of fate's mysteries, it begins with but a small act of disobedience.
Hey! Jack, old Green Stuff told us not to come here.
God damn.
Continue your search for artifacts and Eco. If the locals possess precursor items, you know what to do.
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it in due time.
What are we doing here anyway, Jack? This place gives me the creeps.
Man, don't even look down.
Huh? Oh, stupid precursor junk. Eek! What is that dark ooze? It sure don't look friendly. The sage yaps on about the precursors that built this place all the time. Where did they go? Why did they build this crud? Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble!
Help! Rest in peace, Daxter.
That stung! I told you we shouldn't have come here, and you listened! What? Okay, I'm fine.
In green tarnation do you two want?
I was...
Don't tell me! Instead of heeding my wisdom, the two of you went mucking around in the only place that I told you not to go! Misty Island!
That's right! And then...
And, Daxter, you finally took a much-needed bath, but in a bathtub filled with dark Eco.
Look, old man! Are you gonna keep yapping? Are you gonna help me? Yes!
I'm gonna keep yapping, because in my professional opinion, the change is an improvement. And besides, I couldn't help you if I wanted to.
What?
There's only one person who has studied Dark Eco long enough to have a chance at returning you to your previous form. Karl Acheron, the Sage. But he lives far to the north. Far, far to the north. Nobody has spoken to him in ages. I would teleport you there, but I can't do that either. None of the three sages that maintain the other teleporter gates have seen fit to turn their ends on for quite a while. The only other way north is by foot through the Fire Canyon, but its volcanic soil is hot enough to melt precursor metal. You can't just walk through it.
But you could fly over it, if you had a zoomer equipped with a heat shield. I just happen to be working on such a thing at this very moment. All I would need is 20 power cells to give it enough energy to withstand the canyon's heat. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Yes, Kira, that might work. But where are a boy and a half going to get 20 power cells?
From the villagers. Most of them have a power cell or two stashed away somewhere. And even if they aren't willing to just give them away, greasing their palms with a few precursor orbs should do the trick. And I bet there are even more of them out in the wilds just waiting for some brave adventurer to find.
Well, we've got the brave adventurer at least.
Brave adventurer? You two couldn't find your way out of the village without training. Before you do anything else, you better go through the warp gate and get some practice on Geyser Rock.
We won't find any more of that dark, gooey eco stuff, will we? Because I'd hate to fall in again and turn into you.
Get in there before I turn you both into ferns.
This device is a communicator. With it, my father and I can give you advice at any time during your quest.
Oh my gosh.
These egg-shaped things are precursor orbs. Collect enough of them, and some of the villagers will give you a power cell in exchange. This is a power cell, the most important precursor artifact you can find. You need to collect 20 of these so I can power the heat shield for your A-Grav Zoomer.
Yes. My first one. Hell yeah. Oh, okay. When a following icon appears, to say okay.
Hey! You found one of my scout flies! I sent 7 of them to each area to look for power cells, but the lurkers must have captured them all!
Number 2.
Wow! That last scoutfly had a power cell! I'll bet if you collect all 7 in each area, you can find even more power cells!
That's Blue Eco, which contains the energy of motion. Blue Eco allows you to run fast, break boxes, and even activate some precursor artifacts when you get near them. Notice how each blue eco cluster you pick up increases the time you can use its power. Precursor door. It can only be opened by approaching the door while channeling blue eco through your body.
Thanks, man. Appreciate that. Oh my god.
That's a blue eco vent. More concentrated than the floating clusters, this vent will give you a full charge of blue eco, letting you use it for the maximum time.
Let's run all the way back, open the door. Boom. Open sesame.